Welcome to Evolution Cloud Accounting Training Videos. Hi, I am Ave, your Artificial Intelligence Video Educator. In today's video, we will show you the core rules that apply to business record keeping and the ATO requirements for businesses to keep accurate and compliant records. Businesses are legally required to keep records of all transactions relating to their tax and superannuation affairs as they start, run, change, or sell their business activities. Keeping accurate financial records is an essential aspect of running a business. Some of the key benefits of good record keeping are measuring business performance, tracking cash flow and profitability, meeting tax and superannuation obligations, demonstrating financial position to lenders and investors, claiming tax deduction, and paying only the correct fare of income tax to the ATO. In this video, the ATO Education Team will cover the following topics: the importance of keeping records for your business, the types of records businesses are required to keep and for how long, what makes a record valid to the ATO. Let's get started.
If your activity has commercial characteristics, you intend to make a profit, and your activity is planned, organised, and carried on in a business-like manner, then you're most likely in business. You must declare any business income you earn, and you can generally claim deductions for expenses you incur in running your business. Keeping good records makes it easier to do your tax. In fact, there are many other benefits with keeping good records. You can monitor how your business is doing, manage your cash flow, and show your financial position to banks and money lenders. Keeping good records helps you to have a good understanding of the financials of your business, which is crucial to the success of your business. For tax, you must keep most records for 5 years. Emails and expenses to prepare your activity statements, annual tax returns, and to meet other tax obligations. Generally, records you need to keep include income and sales records of all sales and barter transactions. For example, invoices, receipt books, cash register tapes, and records of cash sales. You'll also need to keep records of all business expenses, including cash purchases. Records could include receipts, invoices, check butts, credit card vouchers, and diaries to record petty cash expenses. And you should keep all bank records, such as bank statements and loan documents. Other records you need to keep include details of what assets you buy and what you spend on those assets. An asset register can help you keep track of these expenses. You'll also need to keep copies of contracts and franchise or other agreements, as well as year-end records, including lists of creditors and debtors and worksheets for depreciating assets. For certain work, car, and business travel expenses, it's not always possible to get a receipt, but you can still claim the expenses as deductions as long as you record the details of these expenses in a diary or logbook. You may have to keep logbooks, lease or loan documents, or yearly odometer readings for motor vehicles you use in your business. For employees, you need to keep records of wages, allowances, and other payments you made to them, as well as superannuation guarantee records, including payments you made and records that show you have met your choice of superfund obligations. You also need to keep records of fringe benefits tax calculations, worksheets, declarations, elections, and supporting details, as well as copies of TFN declarations or withholding declarations. Fuel tax credits are amounts you can claim for the fuel tax included in the price of fuel you acquire and use for your business activities. If you're eligible to claim, you will need to find out the rate you can claim. The rates vary depending on what fuel you use for your business activities. Your business must be registered for both fuel tax credits and GST before you can claim fuel tax credits. To work out your fuel tax credits and to support your claims, you need to keep records showing the date you acquired the fuel, the quantity and type of fuel you acquired, and the business activity you used it in. You should keep records from the start of your business activity so you are ready to calculate and claim your fuel tax credits. The ATO has developed an electronic tool to help you work out your record-keeping needs. Based on the information you provide, the record-keeping evaluation tool will give you a list of records you must keep and a report that shows how well you're keeping your records. It's a clever tool too. Where it can, the report will also include suggestions for improving your record keeping. The main GST records you need to keep are tax invoices and adjustment notes. If you're registered for GST, you need a tax invoice to claim GST credits included in the price of any good or service you buy for your business that costs more than a certain amount. Any tax invoices you issue to your customers or receive from your suppliers must contain certain information to be valid. It must show the date that the document is issued, and it must contain the supplier's name and ABN, as well as a brief description of what is sold, including the quantity and the price of what is sold. It must also show the extent to which each sale is a taxable sale. This can be shown separately or as a statement such as total price includes GST. You must keep written records in English. If you keep electronic records on your computer, they must be in a form that you can easily access and convert into written English. You must keep any account books, records or documents related to preparing your tax return for at least 5 years after they are prepared, obtained or the transaction is completed, whichever occurs last.
Thank you for watching. If you are watching this video from our YouTube channel, please don't forget to hit like and subscribe for more training videos. This is Ave, your artificial intelligence video educator.